Because when we look at the life of Christ, he was just like the Father. He was our prime example. Prime example. Anybody want to add up to this point before I go further in verse 15? Yes, ma'am. Oh, thank you. Brian. Listen to what Brian's got.
Watch this. Paul emphasizes that
that he is fully God in every way. He is fully like God in every way. Not in some ways, but in every way. Because if we're going to be a carbon copy, we've got to be just like. We should sing a song. Those who came when I came up, you should sing a song. I think one of you should sing a song. I want to be more and more like Jesus. And I think the song goes on, if y'all pray me if I'm wrong. I want to be more like Jesus every day. So therefore, I want to take on the attributes of Christ every day. So if I'm putting them on, I got to take some off. Let me use an example. I read Matthew chapter 9. Ooh, I'm not tired now. thank you, Jesus. Matthew chapter 9 talks about the wineskin. You don't know about that. How can you put new wine in old wineskin? Jesus uses this analogy. He says, if you do mix them together, it starts to burst. So therefore, you got to lose one to put in the other. So we got less of us and more of him. St. John chapter 3, verse 30. John says this, he must increase that I may decrease. I must take on more of him and less of me. Wow. To be more like him. To be more like him. Now, watch this before I go to 16. In order, I want to ask you a question. In order to be like the copy, or to be like, in order, watch this, in order for, I'll say it this way, in order for Jesus to be like God, there has to be one main ingredient that must take place. You might know what it is?
Death.
Huh? Obedience. Obedience, yes. I'm looking for something else.
Resurrection.
Repentance? Okay. I'm looking for something else. Okay, watch this.
Obedience.
After you obey, after you have repented, what else takes place?
Worship.
That too, but what else?
Prayer.
Yeah, we'll tell you.
Prayer.
Track, that takes place too.
Oh, yeah.
But there has to be something else in order for it. Got to trust you? But when I tell you, I've never said, oh, yeah, I didn't think about that. But no, this is in regards to Christ. Because Christ is already taught. He's already taught. But there's a key ingredient here. I just saw this.
To be like him.
To be like him. There's a key ingredient. Y'all want to tell you? Y'all don't want me to tell you yet? Oh, shoot.
Yeah, love is one thing.
Yes. But there's something else.
Is it transformation?
You said that earlier. See what I'm saying? Yes. Something else. Yes.
Willing? Yes. Spirit of God.
I have a mind. I have a heart. That mind.
You're getting closer. You're getting closer.
You have to be in love with him.
That woman.
Okay, I'm going to throw this initial out. The first initial, and that's all I'm going to give you, the first initial. It starts with an R.
That's resurrection.
Real?
Real bad. No. Because when I get next letter.
No,
that's next. I think we're pretty slow.
No.
This.
Y'all want me to tell you?
No,
yeah.
Next letter.
Okay, I'm gonna do that. I said I'm gonna tell y'all the next letter, but I'm gonna tell you the next letter. It's an E.
Ready?
Huh?
Ready?
No.
Resurrection.
Okay, watch this.
Receive.
No. Okay, I'm gonna give you, I don't want to do this, but I'm gonna give you the third letter.
Yeah, okay. Amen.
What is one of the reasons that calls Christ to be in the light or the image of God.
Oh, this is talking about us.
No, no, Christ. That's what I thought I did first. But I had to change it. So somebody asked me, I had to change it.
R-E.
Let me tell you the last one. Ain't gonna see. Ain't gonna see. To be that, there has to be a special bond. I'm almost gonna tell you now. Special bond. That Christ and God have a special bond.
Yes,
indeed. Yeah, watch this. I'm gonna use the third letter. I agree. I agree with you. Okay, she said no. Okay. Girls, if I give this third letter, you really gonna give. Talk to me. They had the relationship. That's what happened.
She's a teacher, girl. She's a teacher. That's not fair.
That's not fair.
That's what made it special. Because the father and son had that relationship. Watch this, never let us. We have to have the same relationship with Christ to be like him. I just saw that in my notes and I forgot, I didn't have it. Woo! It's very key that we have that relationship with Christ as Christ had the relationship with the Father. Watch this. As Christ had a relationship with the Father, he knew exactly what the Father expected of him. He knew also the mind of Christ. We all say that. He knew what to do, how to do that. The respect for God and relationship. That bond made them one and made them connected. Made them connected. Anybody want to add on 15? That was 15, y'all. Yes.
It still takes us back for us. Is that love has to be there?
What's got you?
Because that's what God is.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Read 1 John. It tells us that God is love. And we who are of love, of God, are born with love. And that love grows as we progress spiritually. And watch it. I'm connect with that. Because notice the love the Father and the Son had. Again, that's that connection. Again, that's that bond of them. Oh, wow. Y'all make me work with that one. It is, but I don't relationship. If I break it down, I ain't got time to do that. That all of one. But you still got that, all of them had that relationship. They all had the relationship. I can go back to the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost and tell you how to apply. Who said obedience? Somebody said obedience. Didn't you? You said obedience back there. Okay, I'm going to go there anyway. The relationship with God, I'm going to speak. When you got a relationship, you know what to do, you know how to do it. Watch this, you don't go above the person who you related to. And I'm talking about when I say related to the Father. You will notice that Christ did not go above God. You will notice, when I get through reading this, that the Holy Ghost did not go above Christ.
Right.
Now watch this. Turn to St. John, chapter 16. Man, I really enjoy it. Wow. Thank God for revival. St. John chapter 16, verse 13. Since you asked that question, Sister Dan, I'm going to let you go home right now. Let's just mention like you said, like you can. In Jesus' name. y'all got it? Okay, I'm reading from the King James. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, which is the Holy Ghost, has come, watch this. This is his operation. This is what he does. He will guide you into all truth. Watch what else he does. He will not speak on his own authority. Now watch this. He has authority. The Holy Ghost has authority. But he will not get out of his boundaries. I'm using a track and field, Deacon Parks, track and field tournament. He doesn't get out of his lane. He stays in his lane. He knows his lane. I wouldn't use that. Bad now. Back terrible now. Never mind. Terrible. Watch what else he says. He will not work on his own authority, because he has authority. But whatever, watch this, whatever he hears, he will speak. He will tell you things to come. He will only tell you what he hears. He will only speak what he hears. And this is Jesus talking about the Holy Ghost. That's right. But I mean, you need to know that they all have their own place. Still relationship. But it don't go beyond the Godhead.
They have their own place, relationship with God, is what you're saying.
You make me go further than I need to go.
I'm trying to learn.
Okay.
I'm trying to be close to the Lord.
Can I give an example?
Go ahead.
If you are close to somebody and real close, you know what they think, you know how they act, you don't go above what, if you had a good relationship, you got a friend or a sister or a brother, you know them well enough to know what to say, when to say it, and how to say it. Why? Because you have that relationship with them. And you know that you have that connection with them enough to know that I'm not going to say anything, because if I say something else, it might hurt. Absolutely. So you have such a relationship with that person. And you'll know what to say, when to say it, and how to say it.
Let me connect with what you said. Very good. Go back to verse 13. He says, what he hears, he speaks. Again, because of that relationship, because of that bond, and that connection, the Holy Spirit is not going to act. Watch this. Well, I have another word. He will not act out of character.
So he won't care if you're not dead.
That he does not hear from the Father.
That he will hear from the Father.
Yes. Exactly. It says it right here, he will not speak of his own. Yeah, exactly. And that's why it is very, we don't talk about this much, but I'm going to go there. That's why it is very important in the 21st century church that we have the Holy Ghost. Because when those who came when I came up, that's what the old folks taught us. Baby, salvation's fine. They went three steps. They said, baby, there you say baby. I don't know why they said baby, but they said baby. Baby, salvation's fine. The next step, baby, is sanctification. Set yourself apart. And then Thessalonians said, and the very God of peace shall sanctify you wholly. In other words, in order for the Holy Ghost to come in, we got to clean ourselves up. He is not going to come into a dirty temple. And I think, you made me do this, and I'm glad we're doing it now. Because now I'm saying, I'm thinking of something. Because we need to get back to telling people that we need to be sanctified. Because we think salvation is it. Like we talked about it before, haven't we? Now think about it, but we're going to talk about it again. Because I don't think we talk about it enough. Because we get saved, that's it. But we need to be sanctified, and sanctified holy. We need to be set apart from the things of the world. Clean up, because once we clean up, then we're in position and in place for the Holy Ghost to come in. And we need the Holy Ghost. We just read. He will guide us. Watch this. Into all truth. Not in some truth, but into all truth. He will tell us what to do, what to say, how to act, and this and that. He will tell us. It is very imperative that we have the Holy Ghost. Yes. Anybody else?
Mr. I just want to read 14.
Yes, by all means.
This is New Living Translation.
Okay. Now, before you read this, I need to tell you, listen to the New Living Translation. Because opposed to the Message Bible, it gives a clearer understanding of Scripture. Go ahead.
I just saw that in
Thank you.
He will bring me glory by telling you whatever he receives from me.
Y'all can't say it. Why is it? He will bring, just notice what the theme tonight. The glories of Christ, the church here. He will, watch it, God, he's talking about God. God will bring me, Christ will bring me glory. bring himself glory. He brings God glory. If I go back to 1 Corinthians chapter 1, Paul says that no flesh shall get any glory. Or in other words, no flesh shall receive glory. Only Christ. Wow. Wow. Anybody else? We're still on 15 on. Which is good. I like slow walking. Go and make sure we get it. Yeah, we're back to pull it out constantly. Anybody else on 15? Because this has been good on just that first verse. Now watch verse 16. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 16. This is what he says. In fact, let me get back there. There we go. Verse 16. For by him all things were created that are in heaven and that are on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities